MPVP versus the rest of the country, the rest of the student community. It is MPVP versus the Republic. It is MPVP versus the Constitution of India, which has been given to us by Dr. Ambedkar and galaxy of leaders. And that is where the struggle assumes greater importance. We will have to protect our Republic. We will have to protect our Constitution. And we will have to carry forward the struggle. As I stand before you, I tell you, I am son of landless agricultural workers. I reckon will survive. Democracy will have to survive. That is where my friends, my comrades, we will have to carry this struggle. It is going to be a long-drawn battle. Let us not decide as though it is over. It is going to be a long-drawn battle. This battle has to be conducted. One of the senior ministers in the government, he told me one day, we have won the ideological battle. Then I asked him, is it ideological battle? What do you mean by ideological battle? What do you mean by battle of ideas? When ideas are to confront each other, why do you bring sedition charges? Why do you bring Delhi police? Why do you bring all your administrative authorities? Is it battle of ideas? Is it ideological battle? What are you talking? You fascists never believed in democracy, never believed in ideas, ideological struggle. That is where we have to continue this struggle in the name of our country. It is our country. In the name of our country, our India, we will have to fight against these fascist forces, dictatorial forces. And that will ensure our rights, our freedoms, our constitutional rights. And let us not expect any constitutional morality from BJP or from the present government. They have no respect for constitutional morality, which has been emphasized by Dr. Ambedkar, even in the Constituent Assembly. Later on, when he was part of the government, this constitutional morality we cannot expect from BJP and ABVP. So, friends and comrades, it is a battle. We will have to carry on this battle, and our party will be with you, and it is with you. And when Parliament meets, as Comrade Sitaram Yechury said, we will all try to raise this issue and ask the government, what do you want to do with the student community? Because you are not just children. You are not just children. You have the voting right. You have the power to elect who should rule this country, who should not rule this country. Almost we are all voters. Almost we are all voters. And if you can vote and decide who should rule, who should not rule, how can they decide what rights you should have, how what thinking you should have, how you should think, how you should act? So these are all fundamental questions which BJP doesn't recognize, ABVP doesn't recognize. So we will have to fight inside Parliament. We will raise our voice. We will raise this issue. We will fight with the government. Outside Parliament, we will have to continue to fight against these fascist forces for the sake of our country and its future. Thank you very much.
I'd like to announce this. Yes, he will raise that also. He will raise that also.
Already we raised this issue of Najib. We will continue to raise this issue of Najib. And there are many issues, specific issues. We will take up all specific issues.
Dear
why?
Mr. Parliament, last session went on, no one raised the question of Najib in Parliament.
No, it was raised, notices were given, but Parliament was not allowed to function. That's a different issue. But there were notices. We raised that issue. Don't think we have not raised that issue. And Parliament members have their responsibility. I am talking about left and other democratic forces. I'm not talking for everybody.
We have a trust on you.
That's why I'm answering you. I am talking to you. We will raise all these issues.
Thank you, Comrade Raja. Friends, we have Professor Purva Nandhya.